Go ahead. Now, you know what happens when you see the ring the bell?
What'd you think that?
Pass the hat.
Yeah. Oh, I guess everybody keeps that.
That's what I'm doing. I've been working out, playing with this. This is how I'm winding down.
Yeah.
35,000 of them made. I had two of them.
Really?
At my best.
So you like our rods too?
All right. Smile.
So you like our rods too?
Oh, yeah. Did you do a magic shot in this area?
Really heavy duty. Never break down. Been kind of looking for some cast box like pictures.
All that's just work.
Okay, on the set, we're going to just have him recite this little anecdote, get video of it. So, rolling?
Well, you're at the Magic Ranch. Yeah, we call it the Magic Ranch because outside, if you look, you'll see the Magic Ranch Road. And I call this the Magic Ranch because I'm a magician, I guess you could say. And Mike and this was a rock. We went to Sacramento, got rock legally, of course. We asked them if we could have. They said you can take it all if you want. We came back, and I was unloading these big rocks. I had this little rock. I threw it, and interesting enough, it cracked just like that.
All right.
But as I looked at it one day, I said, "That's a shame because it was such a beautiful rock."
Yeah.
Then I realized it turned into a...
That is the mind of a magician.
So therefore, I really had to keep it there.
Fantastic. I'm going to have to take it from you.
Okay.
We are at Bob Caldwell's Magic Ranch, and among these treasures is this square circle. This is the first big illusion I ever owned when I was just a young magician. This was the finale to my show, and the paint job on this baby hasn't changed for 40 years. Oh wow, I haven't even played with one of these for ages now. This takes me back to when I was 11 years old. And I never understood why there was a picture of a sultan on this tube. So you would show all this empty. And when I was a kid, I would show everything empty like this. And then out of the blue, occasionally, a little rabbit's head would pop out. And I wouldn't even notice it. Oh, in this case, there's a bunch of rope in here. Boy, this place has everything.
Okay.
Well, we have here a picture of Senor Wences with Pedro in the box. The story of this was that he would often, like most ventriloquists, carry the head separate than the body.
Oh, really?
And so what happened was the body got sent somewhere else at a show, so he ended up putting the head in the box.
Oh,
and so it stuck. It worked out well. And you know what he'd do with this? He'd have Pedro, he'd work on it, and he'd put the box on the table, and he'd go into his juggling routine with the plates on the sticks. And those plates were heavy metal, you know, and he'd get over there, and Pedro would always be worried that one would fall on him. He'd walk out, so he'd close the box, and he'd say, "All right," and he goes, it's all right.
So necessity's the mother of invention. And they shipped the head separately because it was more expensive
well, I
and fragile.
Because you can't replace it. Yeah,
yeah, but you can replace the body. Gotcha. So that's Senor Wences.
Senor Wences. He lived to 102 years old. He just died here about 2002 or something. He was holds the record for performing on Ed Sullivan's show.
Is that right?
It turns out that he lived down the street from there. I don't know how far, but when somebody wouldn't show up and there was a hole in the program, they would call him and he'd rush down there and be on the show.
Sure. Probably moved there on purpose just for that.
Yeah. It said that, you know, in his elderly years, he would always keep his stuff ready, and at 102, he'd like wake up and that he was getting ready for the Ed Sullivan show.
Sure.
No, great. not today.
That's sweet.
Thanks. And, so it comes up flat, then you can just pack it away, you know. And There's the Indian of the West.
Yeah. And Sachem, the medicine maker. Eat good medicine. She needs it.
The puppets are great for when times are slow.
Yeah.
Because if you're not doing magic shows, you can. Then you got another audience that are children under five.
The duck to bunnies. See? It's a duck. Look, it's a bunny.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I was just showing.
Oh, or is it a rabbit? Yeah.
I love those.
Turnip. I've got it turned. But it actually is the same item, see?
Yeah.
You turn it this way, you've got a duck. You turn it this way, you've got a rabbit.
Do you have any of those
right.
Available? I mean,
no, actually where I got these was there was a fellow I met out here who was a wood carver. Carved those.
Yeah.
Well, this is a choose magic illusion. Inside, what I wanted to do with Jimmy, being friends with him a short time compared to a lot of people, I just went ahead and set up a little, some of the things that he was well known for. This is a picture of Jimmy. I'll just put that right down there. Here he is as Mr. X.
That's what he was known.
This is one of the items that he built. It's color-changing feathers. And this came off of his table, one of his tables. There's a head twister. We usually use this at Christmas time. We mounted it on a stand. I've used that for years.
Down with a little gouge or something?
No, that's the way the bucket came.
Oh, you didn't even make a groove in there.
You produce the little one, it's like, oh. But when you take and drop the little one inside the bucket, mm-hmm. and then open it, and you pull out that monster, it's like, whoa!
Kind of have to spray paint a little
black nose on the big rabbit. Oh, yeah, I've got video of it,
That's an English rabbit, is that the
end? No, it's a Netherlands head, but a Flemish joke leather.
Come take my hand. You should know me. I've always been in your mind. You know I will be kind. I'll be guiding you. Building your dream has to start.
Bring all your dreams
do you got back?
Oh.
It's a private dressing room.
Oh, yeah.
That's great.
I'm not ready. I'm not ready.
Okay.
And for the front, looks good.
I'm not coming out. I'm not coming out until I'm properly introduced.
Come back. Come back.
I'm not.
I said, oh, let me pie that. No, it was the producer of the show.
Oh.
Heard me asking about it, and I was disappointed I didn't get a picture of Brett Daniels.
Oh,
so she come up there and brought it up to me. Yeah, I said, that was sweet.
That is nice.
Where did Brett Daniels show
at? Oh, yeah.
It was Brandon. It drops down here like a soap pan.
Yeah. It's a pagoda.
Yeah, oh, that looks so cool.
Jimmy Kwong.
Okay.
Gosh, I'm not sure.
Kid, look how tiny it is.
It's a very small person.
Yeah. Ducky. Escaping with what?
Strange. Yeah, just put the body out.
That's that.
I didn't see a rabbit. Did you see a rabbit around here? I didn't see a rabbit.
Impromptu, but it's not. It's exactly what you want.
Yeah.
And you're forcing them to put them in the order that you would have walked.
I was never really into that routine that
That's
much.
That's what I thought. Doing that.
It's okay. It wants to.
Do you make this bite? Does your dog bite?
JJ. Your dog.
He said your dog didn't bite.
I thought your dog doesn't bite.
It's not my dog.
Toby, come here, Toby. Come here, Toby. Come here.
Right here.
Oh, that's Toby. Toby the dog.
I'm hungry.
He's always hungry.
You look like a big piece of salami. Yum.
Designed after Jim Jay's.
Yeah.
This is Jim Jay's costume when he was with Wrigley's circus. So they made, this is Jim Jay's. What do we call him?
Mirror
Clancy. Mirror. This is Clancy the Clown.
Where's that Terry go? Where's Terry?
He's on the telephone side. And Clancy has a problem right now. He needs to sit down.
Well, his foot's backwards, yeah.
And
so that's the problem.
There.
Aw.
You guys
want
to see a really excellent puppeteer.
Hi.
Barclay Shaw. Look him up on
Yeah, he's passed away. I met him.
Yeah. One of the best puppet stages I've ever seen. Excellent design. You build a puppet show in 5 minutes. You can actually go in and talk to the people or kids or whoever. You say, you get to see something special today. You know what it is?
What?
You get to see me build a puppet show.
No.
This is the way I do it. It's kind of interesting, you see, because all I have to do is just take my little cage and just bring it up like this.
Wow.
And up like this. And I've got the frame of a function.
Get in there.
You gotta have, you know.